Once upon a time, there was a castle.
Yeah, that one, you know.
In which a young princess.
Anyway, she just, totally.
Her brother, the prince.
Like, what a loser, seriously, right?
And their mother, the queen. All lived.
Yeah, my loser brother somewhere around here.
So not always happily ever after.
Oh, abracadabra, there he is.
For the two young heirs had a contemptuous rivalry.
Tyler's leaving the refrigerator door open again!
With each calling fault in the other.
Can't have much. I'm gonna go play some video games. I just gotta check in with my mom first.
They spent their days plotting out ways to be prideful. They spent their days scheming. They spent their days taking for granted the most basic of basics.
No.
Of all.
Come on, I want to play. Please, I really want to play. You're not here.
But each was too busy calling fault in the other.
Let me play. Come on.
No. It made the two fight, and Queen Mom went to holler. They spent their days taking for granted that matters of family make each home a castle, that family matters and happily ever after is made a bit happier in the end for them all. For the heirs had grown spoiled.
You are so busted!
Taking for granted the privilege they had in their lives, forgetting that others had much lesser stuff.
I can't hear you.
Forgetting their place, but not to be scrappy or bitter or tough. Until finally one day, with her two warring heirs, the queen had decided she'd had quite
enough.
What? No!
She banished them each for the day from the castle till each could call no more fault in the other or in what the other had said or had done. She banished them each until each could refrain from seeking out fault and learn to constrain the words and the actions they'd learned long ago could summon such pain, bringing forth bad reactions. Again and again. She banished them each for the day from the castle, until from within each could discover how to find no more fault in both selves or in others. She banished them each for the day from the castle, until each could see others as selves, all as one. Until each could refrain from coming undone. The two spent their time reflective in self on matters of family, both great and both small. For soon they discovered, in tending to castle, family matters, and made their happily ever after a little happier after all.